In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you. What an extraordinary sight it is to stand here and look out into the cathedral and see so many people gathered for this wonderful celebration of the ordination of 6 new priests for our Archdiocese this evening. I want to say a special word of welcome to every single one of you, no one more important than the other, as we gather as the people of God to thank God for this extraordinary gift of these fine young men, to pray for them, and to entrust ourselves and our Archdiocese to the love and care of the Lord and of His Mother. I do want to say a word of welcome to our bishop, to Archbishop Hickey, to Bishop Sproxton, to Monsignor Ed Whistle, the leader of the Ordinary of Our Lady of the Southern Cross, and a special word of welcome to Bishop Joseph, the Bishop of Da Nang in Vietnam, the diocese from where Tung, who is one of our candidates, comes. So Bishop Joseph, you're very welcome amongst us. On an ordination night, I think it's important also to welcome all of our priests. I hope that tonight will be an occasion of renewal and a sense of encouragement growing in your hearts as you see 6 young men of the quality of these young men step forward for ordination. We have people gathered here tonight from all around the world because our candidates for ordination come from all around the world. I want to welcome in a special way the families of our 6 young men, some of whom have travelled a long distance from the Dominican Republic, from Guatemala, from other parts of Central or South America, people from Spain, people from the United States, people from Vietnam, and probably lots of other places as well that I'm not aware of. I hope that you all feel very much at home and very welcome here as we do gather as the people of God, the community of faith, opening our lives and our hearts to the Lord as we welcome these young men into the ministerial priesthood. As we begin our celebration this evening, let us pause for a moment, thank God for all His gifts, but also acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacraments. I confess to God.
Thank you.
who in governing your people make use of the ministry of priests. Grant a persevering obedience to your will to these deacons of your church, whom you graciously choose today for the office of the priesthood, so that by their ministry and life they may gain glory for you in Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. of forgiveness, sacrifice for sins, and so he can sympathize with those who are ignorant or uncertain, because he too lives in the limitations of weakness. That is why he has to make sin offerings for himself as well as for the people. No one takes this honor on himself, but each one is called by God, as Aaron was. Nor did Christ give himself the glory of becoming high priest, but he had it from the one who said to him, "You are my son, today I have become your father." And in another text, "You are a priest of the order of Melchizedek, and forever." During his life on earth, he offered up prayer and entreaty, aloud and in silent tears, to the one who had the power to save him out of death. And he submitted so humbly that his prayer was heard. Although he was son, he learned to obey through suffering. But having remained perfect, he became for all who obeyed him the source of eternal salvation, and was acclaimed by God with the title of High Priest of the Order of Melchizedek. The word of the Lord.
Simon, son of John, do you love me? Peter was upset that he asked him the third time, "Do you love me?" and said, "Lord, you know everything. You know I love you." Jesus said to him, "Feed my sheep." The Gospel of the Lord. Deacon Patricio Carrera Morales.
Present.
Deacon Konrad Gagatek. Deacon Mariusz, Grzech.
Present.
Deacon Joseph Laundy.
Present.
Deacon Tung.
Present.
Joseph, Konrad, Kenneth, Patricio, Mariusz, if you have any doubt about the enthusiasm with which you're being welcomed into the priesthood in our Archdiocese, I hope that round of applause puts your minds at rest. It's a wonderful testimony to the excitement and enthusiasm and the faith which fills our cathedral this evening. O God, who have willed that your priests should minister at the holy altar and serve your people, grant that the labours of your servants may constantly please you, and in your church bear that fruit which lasts forever. This prayer, which we will soon pray, as the gifts of bread and wine are offered to the Lord, point us to something which is at the heart of our Catholic understanding
of the role of ordained priests in our communities of faith. Through their labours, their constant, selfless gift of everything they are and everything they have to all that the Lord is asking of them, God's people, that's us, will be enabled to bear that fruit which the Lord wishes to bring to fullness in His church and in His world. This gift of a vocation to the ministerial priesthood, and it is indeed a beautiful and precious gift, is given not so much for the priest himself, but for all those who will be drawn through the priest's life and ministry into an ever deeper relationship of love for and commitment to the Lord. And this thought is captured very well in another prayer that is at the heart of our celebration tonight, the prayer of priestly consecration, through which, after the laying on of hands, our six young deacons will be inwardly transformed into living images of the Good Shepherd among us. At the start of that prayer, we will hear the following words addressed to our Heavenly Father. To form a priestly people, you appoint ministers of Christ your Son by the power of the Holy Spirit. To form a priestly people. It is a long and honoured tradition of our church to speak of those in the ordained ministry as bishops, as priests, and as deacons. The bishop, notwithstanding his limitations and his unworthiness, is placed by God at the head of a local church to exercise the fullness of the priesthood for the good of God's people. Deacons are ordained to assist the bishop and his priests in a spirit of humble service, especially in the practical care of those in need. And priests are ordained to share with the bishop the task of leading and guiding the church, always after the example of Jesus himself. But all ordained ministers, deacons, priests, and bishops must remember that the whole people of God is a priestly people, and that as the prayer of consecration puts it, men are chosen by God for the ordained ministry so that through them we will all be enabled to be together the priestly people we are called to be. In our Catholic tradition, of course, there is in fact only one priest, Jesus himself. This is the teaching of the letter to the Hebrews, from which our second reading tonight comes. And as St. Paul makes clear in some of his writings, the priesthood of Jesus is unique. In most ancient religious traditions, priests offered sacrifices of animals or the first fruits of the harvest in order to re-establish a proper relationship with God. Jesus instead offered himself. And in doing so, he completely transformed the nature of religion, showing us what priesthood is really all about, what our priesthood as the people of God is really all about. It is about living every moment and every day of our lives as a gift for the sake of others. It is about being ready to give all that we are and all that we have to God and in God to all God's people. This is how Jesus lived his unique priesthood. And this is how we, all of us, his priestly people, will live out our sharing in his priesthood. To give all that we are and all that we have every moment of every day. This might seem like an impossibly high idea, an unrealizable dream. And of course it is, if we only look to ourselves, or even if we look mainly to each other, for the strength, the courage, and the fidelity to live this way. Rather, we must look to the Lord and to His grace and forgiveness. To be in communion with Jesus and to live from the depths of that communion is to live as Jesus did and love as Jesus did and forgive as Jesus did. And to live and love and forgive as Jesus did is to make our life a gift for others as Jesus did. It is to live a priestly life as brothers and sisters of Jesus, our one true priest. Why then do we need ordained? Our Catholic tradition has always known that God loves the world He has created and that God wishes to encounter us in and through the things and especially the people He has created. This is why the Lord gives us sacraments as the privileged way of encountering Him. Through the created waters of baptism, we are washed free from original sin. Through the very human rituals of the sacrament of reconciliation, we are forgiven, healed, and renewed. Through the bread and wine of the Eucharist, we are fed with the body and blood of the Lord. Through the sacred oil of chrism, we are strengthened by the power of the Holy Spirit. And through the laying on of hands and the prayer of consecration, we are given new priests who are empowered by God to be living signs that the Lord has not abandoned His church and that He continues to be with us as our shepherd and our one true priest. Through their lives and their ministry, our priests are God's unique gift to His church to remind us that we rely not on ourselves, not even really on each other, but rather on the one whose living presence as our shepherd, our priests are called to be. And so, Joseph, Konrad, Tung, Kenneth, Patricio, and Mariusz, in a moment you will step forward and formally respond to this extraordinary invitation the Lord has given you. You will need deep faith, great courage, and unfailing humility. The gift you are given tonight is given for you, of course, but only so that through you the Lord can be present to His people. Tonight you are set apart, but not so that people can honour you and defer to you, but rather so that through you the Lord can shine forth. At this time in our church's history, we realise more than ever before how essential the fidelity of our priests is, and how destructive our infidelity is. Each day, you will have to remind yourselves that the priesthood is about simple, humble service, not domination or control. It is about gentleness and compassion, not rigidity and arrogance. It is about being proclaimers of the truth, but God's truth, not your own. It is about showing people the way by word and example and leading them along this way. But it must be the Lord's way, not your way. Tonight, your whole life is given over to the Lord, to His church, and to His people. From tonight, you are no longer your own. You are His. We pray that you will always be faithful to this call, for the Church needs you and God is called. And here tonight, all of us gathered in the Cathedral commit ourselves to welcoming and supporting and praying for you and calling forth from you the gifts which the Lord has given you. If you are to help us be the priestly people we are called to be, then we must help you to be the ordained priests the Lord is calling you to be. And so, the moment has come. Let us proceed in faith. Dear sons, before you enter the order of the priesthood, you must declare before the people your intention to undertake this office. Do you resolve, with the help of the Holy Spirit, to discharge without fail the office of priesthood in the presbyteral rank, as worthy fellow workers with the order of bishops in caring for the Lord? Do you resolve to exercise the ministry of the word, worthily and wisely, proclaiming the gospel and teaching the Catholic faith?
I do.
Do you resolve to celebrate faithfully, reverently, in accord with the Church's tradition, the mysteries of Christ, especially the sacrifice of the Eucharist and the sacrament of reconciliation, for the glory of God and the sanctification of the Christian people?
I do.
Do you resolve to implore with us God's mercy upon the people entrusted to your care by observing the command to pray without ceasing?
I do.
Do you resolve to be united more closely every day to Christ the High Priest, who offered himself for us to the Father as a pure sacrifice, and with him to consecrate yourselves to God for the salvation of all?
I do.
Kenneth, do you promise respect and obedience to me and my successors?
I do.
May God, who has begun the good work of you, bring it to fulfillment. Tung, do you promise respect and obedience to me and my successors? May God, who has begun the work of you, bring it to fulfillment. promise respect and obedience to me and my successors. May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment. Conrad, do you promise respect and obedience to me and my successors? May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment. Mariusz, you promise respect and obedience to me and my successors. May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment. Joseph, do you promise respect and obedience to me and my successors? May God, who has begun the work in you, bring it to fulfillment.
Let us sing.
My dear people, let us pray that God the all-powerful Father will pour out abundantly the gifts of heaven on thee. Hear us, we beseech you, Lord, our God, and pour out on these servants of yours the blessing of the Holy Spirit and the power of priestly grace. That those whom in the sight of your mercy we offer to be consecrated may be surrounded by your rich and unfailing gifts. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Let us stand.
Draw near, our Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, Author of human dignity. It is you who apportion all praise. Through you, everything progresses. Through you, all things are made to stand firm. To call a priestly people, you appoint ministers of Christ your Son by the power of the Holy Spirit, arranging them in different order. Already in the earlier covenant, offices arose established through mystical rites. When you sent Moses and Aaron over your people to govern and sanctify them, you chose men next in rank and dignity to accompany them and assist them in their tasks. So too in the desert, you implanted the spirit of Moses in the hearts of 70 wise men. And with their help, he ruled your people with greater ease. So also, upon the sons of Aaron, you poured an abundant share of their father's blessing, that the number of the priests prescribed by the law might be sufficient for the sacrifices of the tabernacle, which were a shadow of the good things to come. But in these last days, Holy Father, you sent your Son into the world, Jesus, who is apostle and high priest of our confession. Through the Holy Spirit, he offered himself to you as a spotless victim, and he made his apostles, consecrated in the truth, sharers in his mission. You provided them also with companions to proclaim and carry out the work of salvation throughout the whole world. And now we beseech you, Lord, in our weakness, to grant us these helpers that we need to exercise the priesthood that comes from the apostles. Grant, we pray, Almighty Father, to these, your servants, the dignity of the priesthood. Renew deep within them the spirit of holiness. May they henceforth possess this office, which comes from you, O God, and is next in rank to the office of bishop. By the example of their manner of life, may they instill right conduct. May they be worthy co-workers with our order, so that by their preaching, through the grace of the Holy Spirit, the word of the gospel may bear fruit in human hearts and reach even to the ends of the earth. Together with us, may they be faithful stewards of your mysteries, so that your people may be renewed in the waters of rebirth and nourished from your altar, so that sinners may be reconciled and the sick raised up. May they be joined with us, Lord, in imploring your mercy for the people entrusted to their care and for all the world. So, may the full number of the nations gathered together in Christ be transformed into your one people and made perfect in your kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
the Lord Jesus Christ, whom the Father anointed with the Holy Spirit and power, guard and preserve you, that you may sanctify the Christian people and offer sacrifice to God. receive the oblation of the holy people to be offered to God. Understand what you do, imitate what you celebrate, and conform your life to the mystery of the Lord. Receive the oblation of the holy people to be offered to God. Understand what you do, imitate what you celebrate, and conform your love to the mystery of the Lord. Receive the oblation of the holy people to be offered to God. Understand what you do, imitate what you celebrate, and conform your love to the mystery of the Lord. Receive the oblation of the holy people to be offered to God. Understand what you do, imitate what you celebrate, and conform your love to the mystery of the Lord. Receive the oblation of the holy people to be offered to God. Understand what you do, imitate what you celebrate, and conform your life to the mystery of the Lord. Receive the oblation of the holy people to be offered to God. Understand what you do, imitate what you celebrate, and conform your life to the mystery of the Lord. through all goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual fruit. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
Sharers in his sacred ministry through the laying on of hands.
to nourish them with your word and strengthen them with the sacraments. As they give up their lives for you and for the salvation of their brothers and sisters, they strive to be conformed to the image of Christ himself and offer you a constant witness of faith and love. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as in exaltation we pray. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, which we make to you and also for these your servants, whom you have been pleased to raise to the order of priesthood. In your mercy, keep safe your gifts in them, so that what they have received by divine commission, they may fulfill by divine assistance. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, with eyes raised to heaven. To you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks and said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands. Once more giving him thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for men for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Amen.
I live, my peace I give you. Look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Thank you. Thank you.
Let us pray. May the divine sacrifice we have offered and received, O Lord, give new life to your priests and to all your servants, that united to you in unfailing love, they may receive the grace of giving worthy service to your majesty, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
To be seated for a moment, please. Father, to move on behalf of our new living day, the priest will say a few words to us this evening. Father, to amen.
On behalf of Father Mariusz, Father Joseph, Father Patricio, Father Kenneth, Father Conrad, first and foremost, we would like to thank God for the gift of faith, for calling us, choosing us to be his instruments, for his service as priests of Jesus Christ. We would like to thank his grace, Archbishop Timothy, for accepting and ordaining us to the priesthood. We owe our special gratitude to our parents and family members for sowing the seed of faith and helping us to answer God's call. Despite all the life's challenges, you have been the source of strength and inspiration in our formative years that have enabled us to persevere in our vocation to become a priest of Jesus Christ. We would like to thank our bishops, brother priests, and religious for being with us here tonight. Your presence is a great sign of encouragement. We would also like to thank the staffs and coordinators at Old St. John's Seminary and Redemptory Smart Missionary Seminary for their support and direction during our formation process. We also owe much gratitude to all who have been the most instruments in our lives during this journey. From our hearts, a very sincere thank you. Also, a big thank you to all the priests and parishioners who have welcomed the six of us into their communities during our pastoral visits. Our sincere thanks also goes to Monsignor Michael Keating, the Dean of the Cathedral, and all those who have assisted in tonight's liturgy, the liturgy office, altar service, readers, musicians, and our magnificent choir. Finally, to all of you who are present with us here on this great night of celebration, a most heartfelt thank you. Please pray for us so that we may be generous men of Christ and of his church. And in return, we will pray for you all. Thank you, and God bless you.
Gratitude, and I'd like to invite us all to show out. I know you all want to see the new priests and possibly receive a blessing from them. Before that happens, I'm going to keep them back just for a few moments to give the bishops a blessing and to get a few photos, because we'll have no chance of getting photos once you get on with them. So we need a couple of official photos, so do be careful. I know many of you would like to see first blessings about new priests. I'm not sure what their plans are. I think they might be staying for a while this evening. But many of you will be attending their masses of Thanksgiving tomorrow or on Sunday. It might be easier for you and them too if some of you receive their first blessings either tomorrow or Sunday. But of course, if they're here and you'd like to receive the blessing tomorrow, you're more than welcome. It's been a wonderful night. I want to just say thank you all of you for being here. Wonderful sign of our life, energy and vitality of our church. Let's continue to pray for each other that together we can become the church the Lord is calling us to be, and to become that people who are walking together in the steps of our shepherd. The last word I want to say is that 6 new priests this year, 12 new priests last year. We're rapidly emptying our seminary out. There are lots of empty rooms, both at Predatoris Mater and in St. Charles. Any young man who has been moved by tonight's celebration might like to think and pray hard about the possibility that God is also calling you to follow in the footsteps of these young men. You'll receive a very warm welcome. Please stand now for our time. The Lord be with you.
Bow down for the blessing.
May God, who founded the Church of God so still, protect you constantly with his grace, that you may faithfully discharge the duties of the priesthood. May he make you servants and witnesses in the world to divine charity and truth, and faithful ministers of reconciliation. May he make you true shepherds, to provide the living bread and word of life to the faithful, that they may continue to grow in the unity of the body of Christ.
Amen. And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.